So as you select your trees, another production method to consider are trees that are container grown. And right before me here is a red sunset red maple. And this is a container grown tree. It had spent its entire life growing in containers. So unlike bald and burlap plants that were growing out in the field and were harvested, burlap was wrapped around them and secured with rope or twine, our container grown tree spends its entire life in these solid walled containers. And just like with selecting trees that are bald and burlap, I like to begin with the canopy or the crown of the tree. We've got this beautiful central leader. I see at the top one of the co-dominant leaders was removed. So we've got this beautiful central leader at the peak. And then as we come down, we can see we've got somewhat of a pyramidal shape. Beautifully spaced side limbs or branches. We need to think about this tree 20, 30, 40 years down the road. We want this tree to make money for us as we save energy. So as we work our way down, I like the spacing of branches. I see these little shoots coming off the trunk that will eventually become branches. I'm also looking at the amount of growth this tree has made this year. And so I can see where we have last year's wood, and we can see that beautiful brown color on last year's wood. And then we've got this green tissue, this green shoot, that's probably about 6 inches of growth. So already we can see that this year, our container grown species is growing pretty well, our red sunset red maple. And as we work our way down, I see that we've got a stick here that is used to make sure that we've got a straight trunk. We've got some pruning wounds that have healed. But overall, when I look at the amount of growth produced, the color of the leaves, the size of the leaves, everything looks normal. I look at these side branches, they are definitely less than half the diameter of the main trunk. And I love the fact that this particular tree has a wonderful central leader. So pruning is probably minimal, probably no pruning would be necessary at planting at all. Now, the part that is really critical that you can't do with the bald and burlap is to examine the root ball itself. As I said earlier, this tree spent its entire life in containers, growing from small containers to larger ones. And by grabbing the base of the trunk, we can see the root system and how it emanates from the trunk, but also it extends to the perimeter of the root ball. Now, one thing we have to be very careful about with container grown trees is making sure that the roots we see on the perimeter of the root ball are white in color. That's a sign of health. We also see that even though we've got some dense root growth here, we will have to disrupt the root ball a little bit at planting, perhaps shave the root ball to encourage root growth into the surrounding soil. But I like to turn around that root ball. I love the fact that this root ball is intact. It just wasn't potted up from a smaller container to a larger container, but we've got a pretty decent root ball here. I love these white roots on the outside of the root ball. And there maybe some corrections have to be done with regard to shaving at planting. The other final thing we need to do, this trunk guard, I'm actually lifting it up so we could take a look at the trunk, is we need to start digging a little bit to see where are those structural roots. The structural roots are important to know because they need to be close to the soil surface. And this is beautiful. Looking at this large root coming off the root flare. So we've got the trunk, and then at the point where the roots emerge from the base of the trunk is our root flare. And I could see some very strong structural roots located close to the soil surface. This is beautiful because seeing the structural roots near the surface, I know where to plant it, even or slightly above the soil surface. And I know I've got a healthy tree to begin life in my landscape that eventually will produce benefits for me over its entire life.